So you can see the people from Athens there. We want your participation. This is our score, and you have to help us interpret it. It's preferable for us to stay for the whole hour, but if you want to go out in the middle of the performance, you just have to give us some feedback so we can learn and improve from you. So if you decide now to leave, it's better for you to leave now if you don't want to stay for the whole hour. Okay. And you are being recorded with the phone and projected on this screen tomorrow and archived on archive.org and on YouTube. So if you don't want to be filmed and if you don't want to stay for the whole hour, it's better for you to go now.
Okay, now everyone please take out your phones and hold it like this. And everyone who has an iPhone can go on this wall. Everyone who has any other phone on the other wall. This is also for you.
Also for us?
Yes.
You have an iPhone, will you?
Yes.
voice with it?
Yes.
I have an iPhone, but I don't have a with me, so where should I go?
You can stay here.
Included by the way. If you want, you can interpret it. If you don't want, you can do whatever else you want.
Okay.
So whatever else you think a performer should do.
So we figure the audience, and we need to play them like an instrument.
Okay, I see.
This is according to the score.
According to the score.
Yes.
They are the audience, and we have to play
perform
them.
For them.
You can.
We tune them into an instrument and play with them as our chaos.
We can do it collectively or individually.
Maybe as a group.
Okay.
We can do whatever we want.
Yeah.
Yes.
Whatever you think a performer should do in this performance.
Me as a performer.
Yes.
In relation to
you,
these
if
ideas.
You want, if you want.
I say we turn them into an instrument of some sort.
Okay.
So what kind of instrument should we
turn?
We turn the group of the audience into our instrument. How can we do this? Which type of instrument?
Well, we have to give them some sound material and then conduct them.
Okay, so we have the papers they can use to make sounds.
For instance?
They can flick on the papers. Some of them are wearing shoes. If they have shoes, they have to tap their feet. And we'll turn it into it, and then
you can start any time.
Okay. So everybody
or two, because then
the order. Take two people,
and then they perform with the paper, and we'll come down.
Okay. So tell everybody that their paper will become their instrument. instrument, or if they don't have that, they have to flick on something to make sound.
Okay.
Yeah.
follow each other and, you know, work as a group. And some people that didn't move as fast as us, they were this group of, on the sheet it says, a governmental force or someone trying to stop us from spinning and creating. So when we approach them as we're spinning, we had to stop and turn the other way. And, you know, I think we did follow this for a little bit. Can we see your dress?
Does everyone want to see my dress?
It's the most exciting thing in the room, if you like.
Did you wear it to come to the performance?
I just wore it today. Just to wear it.
Did you make it yourself?
What do you think? Does it look expensive? Can we make that sound without our hands? You know when you laughed at this guy when he took his clothes off using his underwear? Sometimes that happens to me in this suit as well.
We have a lot of very young people in the room. Do you have any ideas? How would you do this exercise?
We're still
in it. A lot of bright young faces. You took off the clothes, you seem like a bit of a trendsetter or a leader.
Yeah, no. It doesn't matter what you do or what you have on your skin or something to show what you, what person you are or other should think about you. It doesn't really matter to me. And this is why I took my clothes off, because it's only, it's something that don't make me as a character. I think it show what I like, but it doesn't show my deepest inner self. Yeah, it's not my best English day today. I'm sorry.
Thank you for speaking to us. We are enjoying this, so I just appreciate that. So you're very comfortable?
I'm not uncomfortable.
So what is the self?
Excuse me?
What is the self? You said that it doesn't
It doesn't matter if you have clothes, or what clothes you have, or if you have clothes at your skin. What really matters is the inside of a person, and you only learn the inside of a person if you put the outer things away, like clothes or haircut or skin color or something like that.
So what's your inside?
Yeah, my inside, I don't know. I think I'm a pretty funny person, pretty kind, I think. maybe. I think. I can tell you that, but you have.
What I don't get is, where did you find this confidence? Like, is it your background? Is it your studies? Is it your money? Like, how did you find this confidence to undress yourself in front of a room with unknown people?
I don't know. I don't feel ashamed for being who I am, or to show that I'm different to other people, because everyone is different, and I don't see any problem in taking my clothes off in front of a room when I get asked to. Someone asked
me.
She asked me to do it.
You seem also to have a lot of confidence. Can you tell us where you got this confidence from?
I think it's important to speak up and be different, and if you have an idea in your mind, or if you have the energy for something, just to bring it out for everybody to decide if they want to join in or not. And if my idea is exciting enough, we have fun as a group, and if not, we end up spinning in circles around the room. So I think it's just about being different and not following, you know, what's written on a piece of paper or what someone's telling you to do. I think it's important just to act freely, dress freely, and enjoy yourself based on what's important to you.
Yeah, but now the person who tells others what to do is you.
Pardon?
Now the person who tells others what to do is you.
Who am I?
Yes.
My name is Graham Smith. I'm a 24-year-old Canadian from Vancouver, British Columbia, and I've traveled around the world. I lived in China for a while, but none of those things really have made me. I think what's made me is just being open to new experiences, and who I am is someone that is happy and just is excited about life.
Is
anyone else excited?
I am.
And who are you?
My name is Mo. For 20 years. Pronounced me Ali. Well, I really am a person in China too. And I think what he and he said is true. And make me feel right now, so I have to think about it.
What do you think about all of us holding our food?
Well, I was at first a bit confused, and I am still confused.
You are
the
one who confuses.
I'm sorry for that.
Look, I mean, if everyone thinks to be individual and to live individually, it's a very hotly discussed controversy at the moment, because somehow society has to go together.
Mm-hmm.
We all, you know, it's a to and fro.
Mm-hmm.
All over the time, you know. You never know. It's about the 99% who have to not be dissonant, actually. Because the 1% always forms a unity, finally. That's what I believe.
So did we form a unity here today?
Yes, of course. After the first few minutes when he started those circles, one of my pupils, by the way, kind of swarm behavior which you could observe.
Swarm?
Yeah, and I guess you,
yes,
you asked Paul to join, wasn't it you, to form the outer circle?
I was just trying to contribute to us.
Yeah, okay.
Doing something while we're here for 1 hour.
Okay.
I'm sorry for taking over your class.
No. I was happy to get rid of that.
Does he give you a hard time? Some of them?
The weather is hot today. First time I see them laugh today.
So who is the 1% in this room? We only had one man wearing over 300 euros of clothing.
It's just because of the glasses. Specifically for my site, and that's why they're expensive. Otherwise, I would be on a cheaper end.
I'm just
going
next to them with your glasses.
I'd like to learn something from you. I feel like you might have something to teach us or speak to us based on what we've learned from.
I think it was interesting to see with something that happens very often in such a situation that those who are the most decided and outspoken immediately take over a leading role or are the ones who initiate something. And then there's a lot of chaos and uncertainty happening, and because of that reason I think a lot of people are just ready and happy to join any kind of structure that comes up. So that's kind of explains the so-called swarm behavior.
Easy adopters.
Yes, because you're more happy to be in some structure, like being moving in a circle than standing around, what's this, where am I, and how does this relate to us?
Can you tell us what you think about freedom?
Freedom. Not everybody in the world has freedom.
Who has?
You decide if you have freedom. You decide in freedom of thought.
Can you tell us what's your opinion?
About freedom?
Yeah.
I think the biggest freedom we're able to achieve in a society is that we decide our restrictions rather than letting other people decide our restrictions. Very often freedom is seen as total freedom, but I think that's something that's quite difficult to handle. Also, very quickly is kind of competing with other people's freedom, who should then have the same kind of freedom. And that leads to a lot of friction. But I think like a more stable and longer basis, the biggest freedom you can achieve is decide for yourself where your limits are. And
everyone can decide that?
Yeah, within reason, I mean within interaction. I think there are some principles, basic principles like of democracy, where your freedom ends, where somebody else's same amount of freedom starts.
Let's decide collectively in the room. What are the characteristics of freedom? What freedom should have as a... like?
To take over.
Take control
of what concerns me and my style and way, not take over everybody else and control
your own thoughts.
Yes, most important.
And what are the restrictions? I asked, what are the restrictions?
Sorry?
What are the restrictions to be free?
restrictions in this society is this newly formed board to control the internet. Consider this society. I wouldn't take it for granted that we have a democracy no more. I remember the last documentary with Occupy tents in front of the Friedrichiano, and then a few months later, all Occupy tents all over the world were just terminated. You know? Okay.
Does anyone think they truly have freedom?
Yeah, to a certain degree.
To a certain degree, of course, but
freedom of course. That's why what I mean. If you are able to choose your own description, then within those restrictions, you decide.
What do you think about the situation?
Well, I think that it is important to have freedom, but it is important to have also restrictions to live in a society together.
Can you speak up a bit?
I don't want to interrupt her. I think it's important for everyone to have freedom and to be free to speak out. But I think it's also important if a lot of people live in a society to have certain restrictions to make life comfortable and also to not let some people take over control as it happens in other countries.
Do you think someone is taking control right now?
Well, in this room? Well, I think, I don't know. I don't think one particular person is taking control. Maybe at first I thought you were like somehow leading at least the performance group. But now I think everybody is kind of trying to get to say something. And I think we're moving out of this one person having control.
But also you stopped him because or in a way made everyone aware by saying it's not about you. So this is kind of like broke this kind of trend. It would have been interesting also to see what happens if
is that what you said to me? Is that what you said to me?
Do you think something changed after I said that?
After that, I think. For my feeling, that changed. And then, you stepped a little bit back and the discussion.
I didn't hear what she said to me.
I think people are now trying to defend themselves, not to be like the one that is trying to control the group. That's what I feel like right now. And somehow I think also you are controlling the group because you're like walking around filming us and asking us questions.
I guess we can never be entirely free in this particular aspect because there will always be people on which we orient ourselves and we always have some idols or people who we admire. I guess so we can never be entirely free and I guess every person we see has an impact on us. So it doesn't matter if they try to take control or if they try to lead a group. It's just that their pure existence in our meeting has just some kind of impact and also an impact on some kind of a personal freedom.
I think we were experimenting with our freedom until she made that sound. I was just speaking, expressing how happy and excited was and what I gained from the group until she decided to, whatever sound she made, I didn't hear it, but stop what I was saying. So I felt like any sense of freedom I was experiencing in the room, it was quashed by.
But it didn't stop us entirely from, like, moving on, actually. It stopped us for a minute, maybe, to, like, listen up what's going on, but then she started the conversation again, and, yeah. So that was maybe just, like, a moment of, that could be dangerous, maybe, in, like, a political situation or whatever, but, yeah. Not in the moment, no.
Does anyone believe that grandma's in control?
That.
Does anyone believe that grandma's in control?
I'm good.
I don't think we can point to one person and say they're in control, because I think we should take ownership of our own control and bodies as well. And we don't have to do what Graham says if we don't want to.
So we're giving a choice to be controlled or to not be controlled.
There's always a choice.
Otherwise, if everyone is totally equal and no one is kind of stepping forward and like, hey, I have an idea, and kind of takes the lead, then it's not much happening. It can be very boring. So it's also something a group can appreciate, that someone makes a decision and has a good idea or a strong idea and kind of is outspoken and says, hey, let's go that way. That doesn't mean that that person is from now on the leader once and forever. There's also the concept of kind of changing leaders, and I think it's very good for a group if the group has this openness for allowing some people who are also competent in a certain area to be the leader for a while, and then someone else takes over.
And that's why I reached out to different people, because I just want to have other people inject themselves into what we're doing. That's why I'm asking you, and that's why you can say something, because I know all of you are very interesting people. We just want to see it. And maybe this is the way I show that I'm interesting, by speaking up and trying to make something happen.
So, you asked those people who are speaking are in control. I want to ask you if you think that all those people here who do not say so much or who do not say anything at all, do you think that those people are in control? Them straight away, they would actually say something, but maybe now they're just not feeling asked or included to say their own opinion.
ask you a question?
Yeah.
You chose to be in the category of the Facebook. And I wanted to ask you, because you have not spoken yet.
Okay.
And you seem to have taken the role of the spectator. If this is the role you also take while being on Facebook.
Yeah. Sorry, what's your question? Like, what are you asking me?
Do you have the same role that you have in this room while you are logged on Facebook?
Why do I log on Facebook? So.
Do you prefer watching people rather than commenting, for example?
No, I'm just listening to what everybody says. So yeah. I'm just listening, so yeah, to what other people say, and then I can get something from it, or yeah. Sorry, I'm a little bit confused.
I was just asking if this is the position you take in your life normally.
No.
So,
no, I don't.
Why do you choose to be silent? Do you understand?
Oh, I'm just here with some of my friends. Yeah.
Presence on Facebook is a performance.
Excuse me?
Do you think your presence on Facebook is kind of a performance?
Yeah, maybe. Because it might not show who they really are. They might post pictures of festivals or them being like totally they have their face full of makeup or whatever, but they are just hiding behind the mask, maybe to like not let other people see that they're not confident or insecure.
Necessarily want to be the goofer, I want to be the one saying everything, but I feel like
don't always have to do something. Silence is good to think about stuff, also for yourself, maybe not for the whole group, but also about your life, thinking about what you want to do, what you did.
I feel, you know, since we've all been into the interactional performance art, I feel like I've had to see it more often from some people, at least in French or around. And I know it's nervousness and whatnot, but a little bit disappointed.
You are just
like,
oh, you're
not? I didn't say I'm an organizer.
Excuse me?
I didn't say I'm an organizer. Maybe I just have a bit too much energy, a little bit too excited.
Well, would the group like to do something? Would you like to stand or sing or move?
Yes.
Do you want to think of a tune in your head and sing it out? Just one tune?
Can we hear a, can we hear a local German song, maybe? That would be nice.
Is there a song that you don't like?
You choose the song and you can fix some Rammstein.
Do you think a song would help the situation?
It could be anything. It seems like I'm just asking a question if anyone wants to do anything, rather than I feel is demanding that something is happening. Nothing can happen, or we can sit here, or we can do something. People can choose.
Could be also interesting to question what the idea of the performance is. I mean, I came in, I didn't come here necessarily to act, but also to make an experience kind of brought to me from the performers. Mm-hmm. And now it's turned around, we're turned into a group, and some interaction is set in motion, and you are kind of in the role of steering the interaction across, which is
and
one
completely with you in this situation. I'm trying to figure it out myself.
Yeah, but I'm just raising the, or putting it out there, and it's also maybe interesting if you think about what another your ideas and why what are you maybe after?
We're looking to, I think, my personal investment in this performance is that I'm trying to figure out what a collective space could be. And I see this discrepancy between people that feel very confident and they always take over, and people who never take over and feel not confident. So I'm trying to figure out how we're gonna relativize or how we're gonna find an equilibrium between this discrepancy between very confident people and less confident people. And this is what comes to my mind.
But
and I think it happens
always the case in big groups, not that there are more confident people in a low statistic. And it's I find it also interesting to think about what can we do against or what does it need to change it. And usually the first step is to make people aware that this is the case, and then those who are the more outspoken ones, they kind of realize and leave maybe also more space and encourage, start to encourage those who are more careful. Mm-hmm. And then it's kind of
started to change from my experience.
I think the most interesting part today, or maybe a crucial one, was when you said after we stopped the swirling that there was a collective force who made people do this action, and then there was another force, and you characterized it as a governmental force that wanted to counteract this. So, like taking in account the fact that you had a very like a position of kind of a leader since the beginning, I found it a bit absurd to characterize like the other action as the governmental action.
It was systemic. It was systemic. It was through our structure. I find what you said very meaningful. It makes sense. Like this was like a God's action. You decided all together just to wander around, and there was someone who stopped that, or like for a reason. This is, I think, what you meant, if I'm interpreting.
Yeah, along those lines, you know, we form some kind of community or group, and then as we're spinning, it's easy to see if it's working fluidly or not as a group. And there were some people in the group that caused it to stop, so we had to turn around and run the other way.
So we're getting sick of it. So I guess, yeah, we have noticed also that also in physical exercises, and people can do some, and some people can do more, and then you have again this discrepancy between people who can and cannot.
Are you an artist? It's a good idea. I like it. It's fun putting a bunch of people that don't know each other in the room and just seeing what happens. And, you know, we experimented today a little bit, and ultimately I think it was gained from it in some way. Would you say so? Well, you don't know people anymore, so we don't know at all.
I think it could have gone to the end. We could all sit here and do nothing. And this would probably be the worst case. And I think that was pretty interesting right now.
So everyone, we're happy with how we spent the last hour. It was the best we could in a room like this.
I believe exactly the opposite. That it's better in this circumstance when everyone is silent, because it seems like that they're trying to figure it out together, and they're trying to think about this impossibility of creating this community based and expressing what all feel in the same time, but with different capacities. And I find more interesting the time that we think all together. I think this is the most collective thing that happens.
Maybe I think it's always that some person don't want to think, and maybe it's not that we need to take care of this person, but maybe we need to take care of these persons most. That's I don't know. I'm too young. that I have no experience in that. But if you don't care, take care of
anyone, you can't be free. If, I think if one only follows another, there's no freedom, there's no individuality. But if you, you don't have this, this individuality, if you tell them what you think, but I'd rather they do nothing but think of ways other people say to them they should think of, if you can follow me. But I don't think your opinion is wrong. I'm pretty good at this.
What do you think other groups did in here? What do you think other groups of people did?
Should we think about that might sound stupid now? No, it's good to think about others, but right now I think it's important about what we learned here, what our experience was, and not to like just focus on what the others may have experienced because we think we did experience something as well, or it doesn't matter to compare us. What do you think would have been good?
I just enjoy seeing people's creativity.
Okay.
From everyone.
Okay. So Ralph, whom do you think hasn't shown creativity yet?
Sorry?
Who do you think didn't show creativity yet?
People that haven't
spoken, I think. So I guess you back then didn't say anything.
Do you want to do something creative? So you didn't say anything yet. Do you want to do something creative?